Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is one of the funniest comedians in the game and has been making us laugh for more years than we can count.
Absolutely. You know him from films like Friday, Hollywood Shuffle, and who can forget alongside of Eddie Murphy and Boomerang, mm-hmm. Honey. And he taught us all how to coordinate. The legendary comedian John Witherspoon.
Yes!
Is here.
Thank you.
Yes. John, how are you?
I'm fine.
You said you saw me doing all that crying and carrying on.
I thought you were in a fight and you lost.
Oh, no. She doesn't lose the fight.
I looked around. I couldn't see what was. I heard, but I thought it was part of, at first, I thought it was part of the show. Uh-huh. But I realized it wasn't. Some people handing you tissue.
Yeah.
So now, what were you crying for?
I love Stacey Abrams so much. She just does it for me.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. You might cry
because you talk to me.
Yeah.
No.
That can happen too.
You make me laugh.
That's right. And you are a legend. When you hear legendary John Witherspoon, how does that make you feel?
I don't get into all that. Mm-hmm. I'm happy to be working.
Yeah.
I drove from Detroit to California to get a job to work in television stuff. Man, I worked, so I'm a legend. That's a long ways away from me.
Wow.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
I go home and count my money.
You still got your money?
Uh-huh.
That's legend to me.
Yes.
Well, John, when did it dawn on you that you were so great at this, that you could make money from it?
Well, you never know that you're great at it. You got to go to, I went to the Comedy Store, mm-hmm. when I drove from Detroit, by myself, by mm-hmm. the way, to L.A., and I went to the Comedy Store, and after many years of honing your craft, then you know you can do it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So being in movies like Friday and then Boomerang, does that ever get old? I know you hear it all the time. Does it ever get old to you?
No.
Yeah?
That's the best part of my career.
Yeah.
People say my line. A lot of people don't want people to say their lines from the movie.
Yeah.
Say mine.
Yes.
Say mine.
Yes.
I like it. Bang, yes. Bang, bang, bang.
Bang, bang, bang. Yes. I love it.
You gotta
it.
Coordinate.
Yes.
Don't nobody go in the bathroom for the next 35 seconds.
Listen, let me tell you, my husband says that to all of us. Look, no, nobody go to the bathroom, and we got that from you.
Yeah,
so,
yeah, boy.
Yeah, well, exactly, all of those. So earlier this week, you know, New Year's Eve, Tiffany Haddish had a bad night where she bombed.
Right.
You know, what are your thoughts on comedians, you know, bombing as veterans? Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't know how long she's been in the business, mm-hmm. but at the James L. Knight Center, it's huge.
Yeah.
40 some hundred people there.
Oh, wow.
It's huge. And you got to have been in the business and done stuff like this. Some promoters, agents push you too fast.
Yes. Okay,
so that's good, John.
If she knew what she was doing, she would have killed. They love. They come to see her.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So I don't know what happened. I didn't see it, mm-hmm. any of that. But I know that 40-something. I've been to this theater many times. Mm-hmm. The center. I've been there many times.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you got to come out and introduce yourself. Hey, how y'all doing?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what she did. But
yeah.
I heard she bombed. I don't know. I don't know what happened, but.
Well, I do love the fact that you made mention of sometimes people push you too fast.
Yep,
yep,
yeah.
She's
yeah.
in every movie I see. I saw her in, on the plane. She's in this movie and this movie.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah.
When did she get this time to do all these movies?
Yeah, and that's what she was saying. She stayed at her house for 28 days.
This whole entire year, the year of 2018.
28 days.
Mm-hmm. Only 28 days. So she is working extensively.
She better be careful.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, your agents don't care.
Yeah, yeah. They want to make money.
They don't care. It's about that paper.
Yeah.
Which I like now, but I don't think, don't get me wrong, but they push you too far, too fast to be. Was anyone else on the show?
I don't know.
No, I think it was just standalone, I think. I don't think anyone else was on the
They usually have three or four acts before you.
Yeah, they may have.
That's what I like to hear. What did the other guys do?
Yeah.
Well, I know what you've been doing down to social media. They say you've embraced social media and you have something called cooking for poor people.
Cooking for poor people because when you're hungry, everything tastes good.
Everything tastes good. Look at you.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, look at that. I don't have no shirt on. I just got some drawers on, maybe some shorts or something.
All right, then. Now, tell me a little bit about what are some of the meals that you make when you're cooking for poor people?
Well, everybody don't agree with my meals, but when you're poor and hungry, you eat anything.
Good fried bologna sandwich?
Huh?
Good fried bologna sandwich?
I didn't have that. I had a fried egg for dinner.
Okay.
Fried egg sandwich, and you invite your lady over and get two egg sandwiches,
mm-hmm.
and you get a nice tall glass of Thunderbird wine.
Yeah.
Thunderbird.
Yes. And you're still traveling the country and doing your thing, stand up. And you're at Uptown Comedy Corner all weekend
all
long.
All weekend long. Yes. Uptown.
What can people expect from this? I'm going to call you the legend. I'm sorry.
I'm Pops. I'm Granddad on the Boondocks. I'm Ice Cube Father in Friday, so I'm all these characters.
Yes.
Yeah.
So they're going to get an opportunity to see that.
I'll be having my shirt on. I have one of them shirts you see me on TV there with a flower shirt and a bow tie.
Yes.
And I'm just going to be out to have fun with the people.
I love it. I love it.
Oh, yeah.
What do you have? What's next for you? Or do you prefer film over television? What do you like? What do you prefer at this stage in your career?
Well, film, I think film is better. Film is better. TV. You got a new script every Friday, you study it, and they change the line, they change this, and then you shoot this thing next Friday.
Yeah.
They give you another script after you finish shooting that one.
Too much to remember.
No, you remember it because you're getting paid that big buck.
Come on, right, man, you better
remember them lines.
That's right.
You better have them lines down. If you can't, make them up yourself.
I know that's right. You probably did a lot of ad-libbing, I'm sure.
Oh, I ad-libbed the scene in Boomerang was all ad-lib.
Really?
Total ad-lib.
Well, it was great, and it was iconic, and so are you. We thank you so much for being here today.
I'm finished?
Yes, you're done.
What the?
If you're in the Atlanta area, please check him out at the Uptown Comedy Corner tonight through Sunday. Let's give it up for John Witherspoon.
Yes.